Life and philosophy of Swami Vivekananda, the great patriots and the world teacher, and perhaps most important son of India. So here I am. We'll discuss about the method of meditation, which will help us increasing our memory power, concentration power, in shaping our personality, confidence and all that. So, Swami Vivekananda said, I will tell you something about him. He was born in Kolkata on 12th January 1863. And his birthday is celebrated as National Youth Day all over India. He has written 4 books: Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Raja Yoga, and Jnana Yoga, major books. And the famous Chicago address also in America. It was on 11th September 1893. It lasted for 17 days, from 11th September to 27th September. There he addressed the audience as sisters and brothers of America. And the whole audience stood up and clapped for long 2 minutes. There he told that I am going to be acting towards you. Sisters and brothers of America, it fills my heart with the joy of speaking to rise in response to the warm and cordial welcome which you have given us. I thank you in the name of the most ancient order of monks in the world. I thank you in the name of the mother of religion. And I thank you in the name of millions and millions of Hindu people of all classes and sects. I am proud to belong to a religion which has taught the world the idea of toleration and universal acceptance. We not only believe all religions as true, we not only believe in all religions, we accept all religions as true. In the name of religion, so many wars have been fought, so much bloodshed has been done. But their time is come, and I fervently hope that the bell that tolled in honor of this convention may be the death knell of all religious persecution, of all religious intolerance. The next day, a newspaper in big letters is photographed. His life-size portraits were there in different parts of Chicago, and he became the spiritual hero of the world Palanquin religion. After that also, he stayed for 3.5 years and visited different universities, different places, and spread our culture, salient features of our religion. And he returned to India in the year 1897, established Ramakrishna Mission in the name of his guru. Again, he went abroad for the second time and left his body on 4th July.